In this session, let's focus on inventories and the various valuation methods regarding the inventories, and how do these valuation methods typically impact the various financial statements, and from there how does they impact the financial ratios, because this is one of the important aspects which should be important for any financial analyst before he puts his numbers and calculations into the financial statement. So from that dimension, let's look at the perspective of inventories. What all an analyst should be considering while valuing inventories or while looking at the financial statement from the perspective of inventories. Now, as we all know, inventories have different valuation mechanisms, right? The cash flows with respect to inventories, which is primarily an allocation between the inventory in the balance sheet, and cost of goods sold in the P&L statement. So these are the two things that are impacted with the various valuation methods. We know that we have a first in, first out kind of a method, a last in, first out kind of a method, a weighted average method, and also a specific identification method. So with these, each of these inventory valuation methods, how do the financial statements really get impacted, and how to build that how to convert one financial model from the other, all those things we would typically look at right now. Right. Now, whatever is the mechanism that the company is following, there should be a consistency in the mechanism. Consistency is very much required, and that will help the analyst to do the comparison or the performance of the company across time, and also with the peer companies. And once the method is changing, it will impact the ratios and hence probably the investment decisions also. So just to look at each of those valuation methods, when I'm talking about FIFO, the first in, first out, so the goods that are purchased earlier, they go into cost of goods sold, and the goods that are purchased later, means very recently purchased goods, they go into the inventory. So that is how the first in, first out mechanism works. The recently purchased ones go into the inventory, whereas the old purchased goods go into the cost of goods sold. So the ending inventory, it reflects the latest and the current cost situation. So in case of inflation, especially the prices are going to go up, because the earlier prices go into cost of goods sold, cost of goods sold may be lesser, whereas the inventory, which actually accommodates the later purchase goods, and because of inflation the later purchase goods are costing very high, the inventory will have a very big number. So when we are talking about the FIFO based valuation method, the cost of goods sold will be lesser. Cost of goods sold lesser could mean the profit before tax is higher. You need to be comfortable with this kind of understanding. The moment the cost of goods sold goes lesser, the profit before tax goes higher, means tax also can go higher. And finally, the profit after tax, which is the net income, also may go higher. Whereas when we look at the inventory part, the inventory will be very high, because inventory is composed of the later part goods. So the inventory will be very high, which means the current assets will be higher, which means the total assets could be higher, and whatever the calculations that are based on total assets, they are impacted accordingly. Now, if at all the LIFO method is used, when I am talking about LIFO, last in, first out, the last purchased goods, they go as a part of cost of goods sold. So cost of goods sold reflects the recent prices, and it is a good reflection of the current prices of the good. So in case of an inflationary environment, obviously this is going to be much higher.